As the United States Ambassador for Global Women's Issues, I want to extend greetings to all of you gathered in Belfast for the first Women in Law and Business Conference. And I want to applaud you for supporting the important role that women play in the legal profession. You are part of a long tradition of women leaders in Northern Ireland who, as peace builders, public servants, human rights advocates, and businesswomen, and so much more, have made enormous contributions to building a better life for all the people of Northern Ireland. Secretary Clinton, a lawyer by profession in her own right, has been deeply committed to the advancement of women's progress around the globe. And as you know, when she was First Lady, she strongly supported the critical role of the women in Northern Ireland in the peace process and certainly in advancing economic opportunity as well. I remember because I was with her on so many trips to Belfast that she made in those days to recognize and lift up the vital voices of Northern Ireland, women across your great land who were making a difference in creating a better future for everyone. As she said when she launched the Northern Ireland Vital Voices Initiative, which was a State Department program that she led in the 90s, when there in 1998, she said, "We are here to advance the cause of women and to advance the cause of democracy and to make it clear that the two are inseparable." Returning as Secretary of State and speaking at Belfast City Hall, she acknowledged the same women who, with their unwavering commitment and extraordinary contributions to political and economic progress in the region, were continuing what they had been doing for so long. This conference in which you are gathering is providing opportunities to hone your skills, to network, to grow one's expertise in the law, and so much more. It is yet another example of women's leadership in Northern Ireland. All around the world, women in the law, whether as judges, prosecutors, professors, practicing attorneys, human rights activists, in so many ways, they are ensuring that justice and the rule of law are a reality in the life of their societies. Women in the law are active in so many critical ways, ensuring that laws are implemented and enforced, that perpetrators of violence against women are prosecuted, that women's rights are indeed protected as human rights, that equality under the law is a reality, that corruption is attacked and ethics is advanced. In some places, women in the law face enormous challenges, even threats to their very lives. You are part of a noble tradition. You are women making a difference. A few years ago, the State Department sponsored two outstanding women judges from Northern Ireland to meet with their American counterparts. Melody McReynolds and Ruth Collins inspired their American hosts because of their commitment to professional excellence and equality. They, like all of you, epitomized the benefits that women lawyers bring to the legal system. I have traveled to Northern Ireland more times than I can count since my first trip in 1995 with then First Lady Hillary Clinton, and over many years since with Vital Voices. I have come to know personally the great women leaders of Northern Ireland. Some are well known, most are not, but each of them has made an enormous contribution to their society, to peace, to economic progress, and to justice. Your achievements are part of this great tapestry. You not only are a tribute to your profession in Northern Ireland, but you are an inspiration to women around the globe who are struggling for their rights and for progress in their countries. You are women in the law, women who are making a difference. I wish you a very rewarding conference, and I thank you for all that you do and all that you will do.